Every Friday, go put on Ghostery on your website if you are a dealer.
Yeah.
And you will see exactly how many tags are firing from your site, right? And it will also show you who the people are. What it does not show you, and I want to be crystal clear about this, is it doesn't tell you anything about what's inside of those tags.
There's another one called Built With that's been
used. Maybe that's the one I use.
Yeah.
It's builtwith.com? Yeah.
That's a good one too, for sure. But I think it comes back to, you know, Alex, we were kind of talking back and forth earlier this week about, you know, sort of these tags and, you know, what's going on, like who's sharing my data and all of that. And I think that it's, you know, it's a good topic to chat about, because if I was going to guess on how many tags were on just like a general dealer site, just run of the mill, right? And not even sort of third party applications. I bet you that there's like 10 or 15 on average at the very least. Go to a news site though, and you'll see the craziest sort of, tag script that pops out. Any, like, you go to like Fox News or CNN or any of those guys are sharing data with like everybody on planet Earth.
So I just ran a builtwith.com. Ran it on our dealership website.
Cool.
And yeah, that's interesting to see. Trade Pending, Auto Lead Star, ironically, they're the two I just mentioned right there up top. Google Conversion Analytics, Fastly.
Who are those guys?
Well, that could be
real-time analytics.
Part of some other, one of these other plugins are using something.
Totally. Like if you've got another like analytics provider that's on your website, like maybe they're sharing data or pulling third-party data from somewhere.
And that's exactly the issue going on in the forums right now, where Jeffrey Tognetti from Dealer X had shown where a certain provider, we'll leave them nameless at this time, but they are using a technology that may or may not be sending pretty much everything that's happening on the dealer's website, anything they can capture, over to Nielsen. So they're selling it to Nielsen, and then Nielsen is selling that back to other, probably other vendors that are then selling it to dealers, other dealers directly.
Yeah. It's tricky, right? And I think that it comes back to, honestly for us, it's not like we've had some challenges, with third party, vendors or scripts that have been on our websites before presented, challenges to us, because we can't, like, we don't have as a tier 3, as a website vendor, we don't have any like visibility into like what's going on specifically inside of that tag. And, you know, contractually at dealer.com, you know, the dealer owns the website, and, you know, based on, obviously there are like program restrictions and yada, yada, yada. But like at the end of the day, like if a dealer wants,
as long as the script isn't taking the site down or is malicious in some way, right? What can you say?
We don't have, exactly. Like if someone wants to put something on their site, that pretty much is, it's incumbent upon, so there's a challenge that's to the dealer, right? To know who your vendors are. And sometimes that takes asking a question, right? Like, so what does this tag share with people that I'm going to put on my site?